Lab?
Yeah, I don't know if netter? I'll be. It's a netter, Carl. Oh,
hold on.
Oh, yeah. Don't want to swing them. Oh, yeah.
Beautiful fish.
This is what we're talking about.
Right there.
Thanks, Carl.
Okay, be honest. How many people throw bladed baits for crappie? Little things, bigger, flashy things, things that attract big black crappie and white, no matter where you're fishing, when they're schooling up, spring, summer, and fall. Honestly, you're missing the boat if you don't throw bladed baits for crappie. It's a fantastic option when the fish are ganged up. You don't want to just throw a float at them. You want to just put these little baits through their face. Let as many fish as possible see these bladed little baits come past their nose so they can eat it. We're going to show you why we use bladed baits, why you should use bladed baits. There's different styles, different applications, and it's not just about cranking and winding. It's about single poling and as well catching crappie under the float with a little fin spin bladed bait and a little soft bait, crappie magnet, whatever you choose. But let us show you certain ways how you can expand your arsenal for more and bigger crappie this year. You talk about turn on. You know what? You're fishing the exact same clumps you were half hour, 45 minutes ago, and you think, wow, are there fish here? And all of a sudden, the sun goes below the tree line, bam, 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 non-stop. I'm just making them little underhand pitches then, dude, right?
Yep.
Here, look at. Letting it fall a bit more. And then a few turns.
Oh, and then.
And then, oh, I missed it.
Oh, that's a nice
good one, attaboy. Well, that's a good one.
That's a good one.
Yes, sir. Got some shoulders on that one. Swing that baby in. Get him in there.
Oh, yeah.
That one just ate by the boat. Put that one in the box, dude.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Just came
grab
off
him, and grab him, grab him, grab him, grab him.
Oh.
Get him. Again. On him.
That's a very nice fish right there. With the sun being. Oh, Carl. Ah, that's a nice fish, too.
Wow, you got to see this. Look where the bait is. Like, when they decide to eat it, they eat it. And all I'm doing is helicoptering it, just letting it fall straight down beside the boat. And all it does is disappear. All you see, and it's hard to explain, is nothing. What's nothing? Nothing is them coming up with that big mouth and sucking in little spin baby. Another one for the box?
Sure,
Carl. That's a good eater, isn't it?
Oh yeah, perfect.
Oh yeah, this is incredible. But that short window from about 6 to about 7, 7:30 is gonna be peak, and man, he was right on the money.
Look at this.
And they're coming out of the weed bed to eat it right there. Look at that, I can see the crappie.
Yeah, there's a...
Look at, I can see them.
Yeah, oh, that's a nice one.
Whoa.
Oh.
Wow.
Nice fish, Carl.
He grabbed it. I watched him, dude. I dropped it down on his head. He came like this, he started to turn, I dropped a helicopter, he went whoop, and all I saw was my little spin baby disappear. Gone, baby, gone.
That's a good fish.
Yeah, good eater, huh?
Yeah.
Again, look at those sharp, those hooks are.
Yeah.
Part of the package, dude. Like, people always worry about crappie coming off. Not those, I'll throw them in there.
Yeah.
Sure. Thanks. Right there, dudes, that little spin baby. But I'm fishing with Sebastian here, and we're throwing some with a little soft body, little blade, and then we're putting a little trailer on the back as well to make an even a bigger profile with a more modified broken nickel kind of blade swivel. So think about that, man. That's a lot of bait coming through their nose, but crappie don't care. Anything from 9 inches to 15 inches will eat these baits. Check it out. Fishing in about 8-9 feet of water, and the weeds come up to about 6, 6.5 to 7 feet. And that's key, because with a little spin baby, it's going, you know, coming across that top of the weeds about 8 to 10 to 12 inches down. And when we see those fish follow, there's enough water before the top of the weeds that we just let it fall in helicopter. And as soon as it starts to fall, it's got that open water above the weed, boom, the fish eat it. In the shallower stuff, 6 to 7 feet of water, that weed is so high that little area between the top of the weeds and the top of the water column is too small. You're getting smaller fish and they just can't have that same opportunity to attack our baits. So fishing in 8-9 feet of water, more scattered clumps, on those edges, those fish seem that little bit of, you know, that range from 18 inches to 24 inches that they can hunt. And then when the baits fall, boom, they eat it.
Oh, I think I got a nice one.
Got a good one? A netter? Oh,
no, I'll be able to swing them in though. That's a
Oh,
nice
that's a good one.
Oh yeah.
I think that's a plater. This one's going
Oh
back.
Yeah.
That's
oh,
a plater.
Yeah.
Yep. Right. Throw that one in the box, dude.
Yeah.
That's a good eater.
And again.
All right, buddy.
He loaded up on that. There you go. Perfect.
I'm going to have another big one for you. Oh, Sebastian, dude.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You need the net?
I'll swing him. I feel brave.
Okay.
But little barn doors, huh?
Well, look at that.
Wide little things. Right through. I want to show that. That little setback hook. Wow, look how far back it is. It's protruding right out there. That's the importance. That's what I was talking about. See all the membrane and stuff here? You get it in there, and you fight those fish, and you see a little hole because it's ripping. But these hooks, the design of those baits, that hook is coming out way back here in the meat. There's no way he's coming off. So what, isn't that wild? I thought the little curly tail bait with the blade is big enough. But Seabass decides to go to even a bigger bait with a bigger trailer, and he's catching even bigger fish. Think about it, man. If the crappie can get it into their mouth, they will eat it, man. They are like largemouth bass. But a couple things. Setback hook, past the membrane, very, very important. Don't worry about the gauge of the hook, okay? The size, you want a little bit of beef to get through and cut into the meat. But get past the membrane. Try to find little bladed baits if you're going to throw the little spinner baits that have a longer shaft and come around, because those will hit the meat a lot more than the membrane. Because you know what happens when they hit the membrane? They usually shake their heads back and forth on the surface, and then they're gone. Oh my goodness.
Nice one. Oh yeah, Carl.
Here, crappie.
Oh yeah, and I got a nice one too.
Yeah?
Oh yeah. Look at that.
Hey, that a boy. Yeah, man. We're almost getting spoiled, right?
Yeah.
You know? Do I love throwing little bladed baits for crappie? You bet I do, man. And this next couple examples show you on a just nasty day, cold front, rain coming down, wind, you think they would just be sort of shut down. You need to put either a single pole or a float and let it sit there. No way. These fish wanted the same little bladed baits with the curly tails, soft bodies, cast over their head and brought right through the schools. When you find the school, that's the imperative part about using these bladed baits. You can locate, you find a weed bed, you can dissect it quickly and find the most aggressive fish, hence the bladed baits. That's why a lot of guys throw spinner baits for smallmouth and largemouth. Find the most aggressive fish as well, and then maybe just tone down, slow down, throw plastics. But on this afternoon, I didn't have to. I kept throwing the exact same bait, changed the color up, and just altered it as slow as I could possibly go. And these fish killed it. Big ones don't mess up. They just whoa, like that. I got a feeling. Oh yeah, it's got weight. Got weight again, dudes. Oh boy. Come on. Big, big crappie. Let's see. Look on the surface right here. Look at. Oh yeah. Look at those big ones go on the surface. Look. Oh my God. My. I don't know what to say, man. Phenomenal. Phenomenal little bait, boy. You gotta get some of these gorgeous little fish. I got enough of yous. I'm gonna let you go. Yeah. Ready? You believe it? Do you believe it? Go on. You can't. You know what? I'll stop describing it. You just gotta do it. Cast out, engage, slow roll like this. La la la, minding my own business. Not doing anything, just walking along, going through the weed bed with that little spin baby, and just all of a sudden it just loads up. There's a numbing feeling where they're just going, they're pulling it in. Remember, crappie eat the same way as walleyes. They're just in, like they, you know what to do? Let me show you. The bait's coming by, and their gills just flare, and they just inhale. So when I can get away with it, I'll use a much smaller. This is 1/8 ounce. These spin babies come in 1/4 ounce and 1/16 as well, but I want that slow fall going through their water column. I want it to stay as long as it can stay in front of their face. Drives them nuts, just like smallmouth, you know, any other fish. But I mean, they just So it's that numbing feeling, and with the Crappie Wizard, I just can just lean back, set, it finds a mark. Oh, wow. Look at that again. Oh God, man. Oh my goodness. Is this ever fun? Look at the longer rod, light action. You know it's good crappie. He's shaking his head, but I want a giant. Oh, another nice one. You cannot complain, man. You cannot complain with fish like that on a rainy spring day, man. Wow. Seriously, this is just insane in the membrane. Okay, decision time. Is this an eater or releaser? For today, she's a releaser. You're lucky, boy, because I'm after some big fat slabs. Go find me a big fat slab, will ya? Real big one. I want a 14, 15 inch slab. Maybe there's a 16 out there. Let's see. How can you not think that's not exciting? I mean, just casting out, man. It's just like I'm bass fishing, but catching these big, beautiful black slabs and just putting that bait right over their head. And sometimes I just stop it, let it helicopter, which means I'm the cadence, steady, slow retrieve, and then just stop it. So the bait, this little bait just falls in their weed bed. Sometimes those fish only have the option of eating it because they don't want it to get away, or they're underneath it, falls on top of their nose. Change up the cadence sometimes, let the fish show you what they want. Because most times, if you change it up a little bit with the right bait on the right spot, you'll catch them. Slow roll, that's it. Slow roll. When I think I'm going too slow, I gotta slow it down. All you want is that little blade just to turn. And that little shadpole CT, that little tail, that little back end, you know, even in the wind, it moves. You know what I mean? Even in the wind. So in the water column, no problem. Those fish see it. You just slow roll it through that school of fish. They're gonna eat it. See that? Wow, feels good too. Oh man, don't they all feel good? Well, no, this one's got some weight. Good thing I brought the net. Let's see. Are you thrashing on the surface? Or you're just another beautiful crappie? Oh, you are, look at that. Oh my God, look at that. Oh, there's a nice one right there, boy. Nothing wrong with that, man. And it's a weird bite. It's almost like a sensation, like a numbing thing, like all of a sudden there's nothing there and then there's weight. Oh yeah. But that little curly tail on the back of that little inline spinner, been around forever, man. There's been so many different baits like this. But Strike King came out that with Mr. Crappie Wally Marshall, and they've got that longer shaft hook, real sharp hook. And they put on that little shadpole CT, and look how it just turns in the wind. Look at it. Now under the water, you can imagine. Crappie, see that? It's done, man. And I tie right to the little R-bend, no terminal tackle. It's just the B&M to the line, to the bait, to the fish. All them bites be in the same areas. Let's put it back here. Come on, fish. Where's the great big crappie? Patience is the key, man. I'm looking for bigger fish. Water's still somewhat cold, only like 51, 52 degrees, and that's on the surface. So I don't know what it is down there. That's got some weight again. Look at that. I think that's a big slab, dude. Big slab. Come on, big slab. Is that one of my big slabs of the day? Let's see. Oh yeah, look at that. Wow, look at that. Here's one of my big slabs of the day, right there. Oh wow, look at that, man. Beauty, beauty. Whew, I don't take a chance with old paper mouth, man. Look where he's got it too. Right down inside the schnoz. Oh, just pops out. Do I love you crappies or what, man? Making my day, you know, just a perfect size. When you find that school of fish like that, that's nothing to complain about, man. We're about to get nasty and dancing. Not me, the baits. Tugged on to a little fin spin. my buddy Josh and I, late October, put these little baits to the test. Little kick and tails on the fin spin. We got the fish ganged up. It was the feeding time when they're pushing bait all to the surface. They wanted to eat something fast. I was throwing the float. I was only getting one fish every five that Josh was getting. And I put that float down pretty quick. Because when those fish get aggressive and they're schooling up and stuff, they just want to eat. They want to chase. They're right below the surface. So we'd cast. As soon as it hit the water, you start your retrieve. And bang, we start catching fish.
Now, when you start seeing pods of fish like we're seeing here, I mean, you talk about exciting. You know what? Two guys giggling like little schoolgirls, man, catching fish like crazy and stuff. But it got to a point where we're getting so excited that you throw your float and you're just waiting for it to go down. If it doesn't, you're seeing like 10 or 15 crappie about 15 feet to the right. So Josh picked up right away quickly the little fin spin with the new dancer, the crappie magnet, and it was on big time.
But I mean, this is not kidding, man. It is so loaded
there
right there.
First cast.
See?
Boom.
Yeah, man. I need to do that too, real quick. Real quick.
Boom! On the fin spin with the new dancer. Look at that,
man.
Whoa, yeah.
See, we are.
Oh, it's go time, guys.
The fish are boiling absolutely everywhere. It's pandemonium. Everywhere you look, it's push, push, push. And you're like, you're using your mind trying to see where they are, but they're everywhere. So we put these suckers down. Grab the horizontal baits here, the fin spin, the chartreuse dancer, and let me tell you something, it was legitimately pandemonium. It was crazy. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 fish in a row. Bang, 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 you cast it out. 3 or 4 wines, bunk fish. It was just insane. I don't know what to tell you. This is the deal.
Back to back on the fin. Oh boy, here we go.
Right here.
Oh, all right, all right. We're on them. It's go time.
With the dancer again, huh?
Oh, dude, this new bait they got coming out. Folks, be ready for the dancer. Look at this thing. Woo! Pure gold is what that is. Boom.
Unreal when they're feeding like that. Like whales,
dude,
eh?
This is epic. You can just see the little tails in their mouths coming out. You cast in it, you start reeling real slow, and bang!
Like right there?
Just like that, buddy. Wow.
Whoa, whoa. Wow. The dancer gets a hog, dude.
Oh, right beside the boat, 3 for 3 here with it. Look at that. Right beside the boat, 3 for 3.
Woohoo! Slap me in the face with the crappie. Slap nappy.
You got to remember sometimes it's about the size of the bait too, okay? In fall, we were in an area with a whole bunch of small little minnows, maybe 2 inches long. So that little blade kicking underneath the bait like that, okay? Look how it looks underwater, kicking along. That little kick and tail, little soft little body, pick whatever color you want. But the little blade with the head pushing water, the crappie could not resist.
Yes.
Is that 4? That's 4 in a row on the dancer and the fin spin, boys and girls. Woo! Look at that. Tell ya. This. Oh, he almost went for a swim back. I don't think so. Oh, Carl's got a big one coming in here too. Look at this. Jeez. Absolute pandemonium. Let's go!
When people say foot's pandemonium, they'll just show this in the dictionary one day. Huh?
Yeah. Look, and then you get all the little tangles and you're like, ah, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go back out there.
Look at that little bait. Tiny little tail, I'll show it to you. But on the fin spin, you just gotta keep putting it out. I got braid, I think Josh has got braid. Nano. And just in front of the boat, and I mean slow rolling, dude, right below the surface. They're right up high pushing the bait. And when they see that little spin and that little kick and tail,
that vibration,
it's just eat. There's no guess.
You know, it's very, very important to be prepared because, you know, when there's a frantic bite going on, you want the rods ready. So we had a couple float rods each put aside with different depths fishing. We had different fin spins, the Pro Series fin spin. But something about that new little dancer, we just cast it about 20 feet and slow rolled it as soon as it hit the surface. These fish were busting bait right on the surface. You couldn't even go slow enough. I mean, it doesn't matter if we ripped it. We were just slowly going. That little tail kicking was unreal. You'd hook a fish, lose a fish, and just keep reeling while you're giggling and hook another fish. Some of the biggest crappie I was hooking into were about 2 feet from the boat.
Wow. Did we move off a bit?
No, I got another one. This is a good one.
This is a good one. This is a nice
hit. Can you get him okay?
Yeah. Not even that nice, just crushed it. But Carl, if you look back here, I just saw about a 50 of them in there.
Okay.
And behind us again, look. Okay. Oh my gosh. This is insanity.
Like another one. Another one.
Look at that. Man, I just had five casts in a row.
Oh, I just lost a good one, dude.
Like five casts in a row. What else do you want? Woo! Look at the pile of them over here. Look at this. Look at the tails.
I know. It's unbelievable, dude, what we got right in front of us here. Wow.
This is sickening.
Oh, I lost them.
This is just sickening.
Wow. Another one. Oh, my God, dude. It doesn't matter. You lose. You just keep bringing the bait in. Look at this one, Josh.
Ooh, oh, donk.
Look at this.
This is too much.
Look. Look at that. The bait is like, oh my God, dude. Unreal. Unreal. Crappie fishing in early October on a perfect, beautiful night. And we're throwing the dancer, the fin spin, and we are having the time of our life.
Oh man. Wow, let me tell you something. Had I not been here on this trip, hanging out with these cool guys, man, let me tell you, I would have never had the chance in my lifetime to experience such a phenomenon, let alone within driving distance of the GTA here. This is insane.
Now, would you throw this little bait under a float? Sometimes that's the answer. Late spring, high sun, the fish didn't want anything, man. I swear I threw almost all the things in my tackle box, including tube jigs. I even upsized, changed the colors and stuff. But until I put on that little fin spin, little bladed bait under the float, cast it to those fish and kept twitching. Twitch, twitch, twitch. Keep that little shine, you know, maybe look like little minnows were injured and stuff. That's what the fish wanted. They were suspended on those weeds, and every time I kept casting to the same area, close to the marker buoy, locate the school, after the twitch, let the float sit, the float would just go down.
Okay, bright sun. Deep weed beds, offshore, how do you do it? Bluegills and crappies. Sometimes just changing up a little bit from a traditional soft plastic to something with a little flash. And for me, there's no better way right there. Crappie magnet, fin spin. Slip float, vary the depth, and try to find some crappie on deep weed, maybe mixed in with some bluegills. Uh-oh, big slab. Yep. In that weed, dude. In that weed, the fin spin, and the crappie are waking up, dude. The crappie are waking up with the bluegills. The crappie are waking up. That's a decent fish. Good eating size fish on the fin spin. Look at that little bladed thing. I put that float down, man, almost 7 feet. Now I'm getting like some eating size crappie to go with the bluegill. Let me show you. Basically, simple setup, boy. But look how far down I got that float now. Here, there's the fin spin. So that's, 6.5 feet probably. The slip float just whooshed all the way up. Little sinker to keep that float vertical. My little 1/16th ounce crappie magnet fin spin with the crappie magnet little bait on the back. Fishing over some deep weed. Let's see if we can get a couple more. You don't want to come out of the weed. You got to put it in it on top of their head. Then they'll eat it.
Sometimes it's a stationary well, you know, single poling, under a float. Consider it. That's why it's so important to have different styles and different sizes and different colors of blade baits in your boat or from shore. Whatever you need to do, just keep changing it up until you find out what they want. The size, the bait, the color, doesn't matter. Whatever gives you confidence is what works that day, and it could change from hour to hour. Doesn't matter what the guy beside you is using, you use what gives you confidence, because trust me when I tell you, that's one of the biggest things in fishing, confidence.
Crappie? Yep, look at that. Oh boy, nice crappie too. Oh boy, I'd say. Let's see where you were, right on that other side there, eh? Man, oh man,
love the fin spin, don't you? I'd say. Oh, nice crappie. Wow. Love that, man. But as you can see, it is not fast and furious. They are not ganged up. My money says they're in that weed, taking their time to come out. And I'm getting lucky by putting it on the right little spot. And again, using a marker buoy, I'm using a reference of where they are, but that just slight breeze pushes me off it. And when I'm off it too much, nothing. It's like they're not even here. When I get it back on the right spot, over about 11 feet, I get bit. Either bluegill or crappie. Okay, as for sizes and stuff and colors, crappie magnet and the fin spin, they've got like 1/8 ounce with the big pinks, okay? A little bit bigger than I want to use today. I'm using 1/16 ounce. They got 1/32 as well, and chartreuse and white, plain chartreuse. And here's some other things. Orange, chartreuse, pink, pure orange, and chartreuse. Very simple. Got selection, it's got variety for people who want different colors. Everyone has their own favorite things, but I just put a little crappie magnet on the back of it with a slab bite, and I'm ready to go. Again, it drifts so fast. There's a good one there too. Again, oh boy, look at this. Oh boy, exactly what I came for right there. Exactly what I came for. A meal of crappie with the fin spin. Oh boy. Sometimes you need a little flash to get him going. And that little fin spin does it, the crappie magnet. Yeah, he's a good size. If I get any ones that are like 12, 13, I'll call them out. But I'm looking for crappie to eat. A little fin spin and float, catching some bluegills and crappie for dinner. That little flashy blade, you can cast it horizontally and work it over weed beds and a rock and stuff. You can troll it behind, long line. All, it's so versatile. But I like putting it underneath that float and just twitch it ever so slightly. Keep moving that little flashing blade. That little flash and stuff, they see it, man. Crappie are very inquisitive. Bluegills, man, anything that they see, they'll go and eat. But those crappie, they see that little flash back and forth. It gets their attention. They come over and let it sit. And all of a sudden that float just sometimes bumps and goes down nice and slow. The fin spin and float, another tool for your arsenal on catching panfish.
Now, you know I was going to break out the jig pole as well too, right? No episode is complete without picking up the single pole. I found some scattered weed beds in a dirty little back bay off a main lake, and they were in there. Okay, so I used the bright orange with the chartreuse head, little blade as well, orange chartreuse. You can use bright chartreuses and stuff, but you want to offset it in that dirty water. I just stayed back, used a 12-foot pole, and slowly just dropped the little fin spin between those weeds, shook it up, and then felt that boom, thump. Looking for big fat slabs, single poling with a bait that you've seen, you've heard about, you've seen it all over the internet, and you've seen it on the Xtreme Crappie Angler, and that is the little fin spin, a crappie magnet. Today, I'm gonna try this morning this little bays and cuts in different parts of this big lake that I'm fishing that have warmer water than the main lake. What I'm going to use, 12 foot SAM Super Sensitive by B&M with the bottom reel seat. So sensitivity wise, it has the blank through the handle there with a soft cork. I can fish this all day long with no fatigue. It's incredible the craftsmanship of a 12 foot pole holding it out all day and not getting worn down. Like that. That's how you do it with the fin spin, dudes. Warm water in the morning. Keep your glasses on and you see them. Wow, look how we took it. Wow, sharp little fins, eh? Look how we took that. Wow, this is it right here. A little head, a little underspin blade for some flash. And I got this one in the orange chartreuse with a yellow and chartreuse body and the nice, really sharp gauge hook. They've got good gauge wire on these fin spins. They don't open up. And I'm anticipating catching some big black crappie. I'm going to be boat swinging them so that hook cannot open. Otherwise, I'm going to lose them. But I've caught enough fish with the fin spin to know that the hook is quality. It's got the craftsmanship, a little flash. I'm gonna find different areas and hopefully catch them. Wow. How's that for some nice crappies, hey? How's that? Wow, that ever exciting. It's incredible how they sit in those weeds, but as the sun gets up in the afternoon, I bet those fish can be right uptight. It's the warmest water right at the top. They pull right up, but they can be a little spooky to catch. Right now, they're down about, I'd say, 18 inches. So I put the little fin spin down, lift it up, hold it, sometimes swing it a little bit. So that little blade, moving back and forth like that, attracts those fish. Because when they see this bait, you see what happens. They eat it. So I can use my rod, lower the line with my hand as well. And it's really sensitive. I can feel the bites too. And these poles have that blank through the handle, so you can feel those sensitive bites too, but these ones are inhaling it when they do eat it. How can you not like the little bladed baits? I mean, under a float, cast and retrieved, single poling, these little things do it all. You got to get whatever styles you want in your boat, but you got to have bladed baits to catch them horizontally, under a float, or vertical jigging them inside the weeds like I'm doing right here. It's a 12-foot pole, so if I lift up my line, there's 24 feet from me to the actual fish. 12 foot of the rod, 12 foot of line. I can cover a lot of water around the boat, not have to move the boat. Fishing, you got them dialed in one weed bed like this right here. It's so important to wear eyewear when you're fishing shallow. Now, fishing in general, you know, there's a few things I probably wouldn't even fish without: the trolling motor, obviously hooks, but eyewear. You gotta protect your eyes. You only got two for your life. So the harmful rays bouncing off the water back and forth, hook sets, hooks flying, think about it. But a lot of times those crappie, what you see is what you don't see is those fish coming up slow like a shadow. You just see your bait disappear. And then because the blank comes through the handle here, you feel those bites with your finger there. Plus I've got my hand off to the side with the line. There's no mistaking the bites. Oh boy. Yep. Easy now, Carl. Just keep moving through the weed bed slow and methodical. And this is what happens. Right there. Slow to go. Catching crappies with the little fin spin. See, just bend them back. Those sharp little hooks, man. Look at that. Nothing wrong with those, eh? They're gorgeous fish, man. Okay, here's the two different fin spin. I got the 1/8 ounce and 1/16 ounce in the orange or chartreuse. And they've got, as well, the fin spin Pro Series. So you want a bit more flash, you want a little bit of tail, you got tinsel, you have that option here too. But I'm like real small because I got the small crappie magnet on the back of that one here and the 1/8 ounce in chartreuse. I've got the slab magnet. So different size options, because I'm gonna hold it, lift it up right near the top. I don't need a heavy bait to go down different deeper water or through weeds or that kind of things. I'm fishing fairly shallow. So the smaller profile I can get away with, I think I'm gonna get more bites. Little guy. Yep, just a little guy. I think I went through the bigger fat slabs. And the little ones want to come to eat too. Wow, he took that right to the cheek. There's no way he was ever coming off. There's no way. That fish was never coming off. Now, think about that, man. I call this the fin spin spectacular. I cast it, drift it, all kinds of ways you can fish this bait. But when you can vertically jig with a single pole in some shallow weeds and then set and see those big fat slabs, think about it, man. The fin spin. Add it to your arsenal, because it's going to help you catch more and bigger crappie anywhere you fish. That's what we're looking for. The back of a canal. Well, easy, easy. That's what we're looking for right there. The back of a canal. Real slow, methodical. When they're on, and it's calm, you can fish them. you catch them. Well, there you have it, man. I hope you get convinced that blade baits are the answer sometimes. The big, bright, obnoxious stuff that look like you're fishing for bass. Some of the ones with the little blade with little kicking tails and plastics and stuff horizontally or under a float with the little fin spin, little soft bait, crappie magnets and stuff, or single pulled them. This is another arsenal in your toolbox to catch crappies. We appreciate you watching our content on our YouTube channel. If you have any comments, hey man, post away. But please subscribe. Please tell your friends about us. Maybe share our videos on your platforms. And we'll see you next time right here. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.